Hello and welcome to Various Random. And today I'm gonna show you another Karens in the Wild. I hope you enjoy it as much as I do. Please hit that like button and subscribe button if you haven't already done that. And let's dig into yet another episode of Karens in the Wild.
So this lady right here won't let me get out of my way. She is all parked in front of me, being a major Karen, with her kids in the car, cussing at me, and want to say how she's just going to sit there and drink her Slurpee. For those of you that saw the Home Depot incident with Karen, Karen found this TikTok, the previous TikTok, and is commenting. So to get things straight, I pulled from my spot through the front spot, and she was coming down, slammed on her brakes. She gave me a look. I gave a little wave and she got all like that. And I went like that back to her. I didn't know what her problem was. I gave her the wave. She pulled up, started cursing at me. I said, go park, Karen, because she was being a total Karen at that point. That's when she started cursing some more. And then I'm not moving. I said, fine, I got all day. I'll sit here. So then she wanted to sit there and blah, 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 and just sit there and look at me and drink her Slurpee. Her whole aspect that I was speeding through the parking lot, kind of hard to speed when I was going 10 feet. Plus, I was only 7 spots from the front of the store. Nobody cuts through a parking lot 7 spots through the front of the store, Karen. We all do it at the back of the parking lot. That's how you cut through a parking lot, not at the front. Okay, TikTok, you've made your point. Karen has sent me a direct message asking that I take down the video. I'm not going to take down the video. I don't believe in censorship. Although, I do ask that people, if you are direct message, stop direct messaging her. Don't harass her kid, her niece, whoever may be on there that you guys have all seen their ads. Just let it be. Don't be a Karen yourself. I will say she didn't apologize, but neither here nor there. She thinks she's right. I think I'm right. I think we all know the answer. But we have learned a few things. One, don't be a Karen. We saw what happened. Two, don't cause confrontations in a parking lot. Based on the comments, that could have gone really bad for her. I didn't step out of the car because I know better. Anytime you step out of a car, something bad can happen. Three, walk away. Four, with the internet, walk away. You can scroll. You don't need to comment. If you argue on the internet, you're going to lose. And five,
they parked in our space. So we decided to call the tow company for the first time. We had to park like this until they came. 2.5 hours later, I wish the owner came outside to see their reaction. Bye bye. Thank you.
So I've been getting a lot of dumb and ignorant comments like this one. So let me go ahead and give you guys a little story time. So I live here in Oregon where parking is horrible. I mean, horrible. And the complex that I live in has very limited visitor spots. So I can understand somebody parking in somebody else's space for a short time, you know? But that's not the case here. I get off an 8-hour shift. I'm ready to go home, relax, chill. I get to my complex, and what do you know? Somebody else is in my spot. So, you know, I mean, I'm not really mad. I'm not really frustrated, you know, I'm chilling about it, I'm cool about it. My only issue is, where the hell am I gonna park? I've seen people get towed, a lot. So why would I risk my car being towed for somebody that's parked in the space that I pay for? Yeah, that doesn't make sense. And then I got people also saying, well, you should have left a note, or you should have went door, you should have knocked or tried to find the person. The fuck do I look going and trying to find somebody that I don't know? Mind you, there is way more than 13 buildings on this property, so what? I'm not going door to door trying to find somebody. That's a waste of time. That's so stupid. No. So 2.5 hours later, the tow truck finally arrives. The owner still hasn't came outside. So I showed him proof that I paid for this parking space. And as y'all seen in the video, he hits that motherfucker up and see ya. So I waited another 30 minutes waiting for the owner to come and see his car got towed. And he never came. So I didn't really get to get no reaction and see what the hell was going on, but they shouldn't have been parked in my space. And, hey, it's their fault. Now they know the consequences of parking in somebody's shit. Like, I paid for my shit. Sorry. Like, follow, comment what y'all think, man.
So for everybody that was wanting to see it, here goes one sign right here. They're literally all over this property.
My neighbor breaking down my fence for no reason. Police did F all.
Breaking the fence panel even more.
Is she actually?
She's pulling it all down.
She's what?
Pulling it all down. Just throw it on top of my plants.
Why? She's lost the plot, hasn't she? I just don't get her. One minute she's giving me cakes and then the next minute she's ripping the fence down again.
She's just moved all the bricks. No, it's alright. Yeah, fall over, silly woman. Don't care. Pull the bit out the bottom because she's rammed her bricks so far close.
Mum, shall I open my curtains? Just open them normally so she knows.
Why?
I'm video recording it to send this to the person. She just saw me.
Just when you think you can trust your neighbor, my neighbor thinks he's slick dumping his dirty water to my backyard. Love all the suggestions. Majority was between plug it or reroute it. We rewrote. Let's see what happens. Problem solved. Jerk took his pipe down. I bet this won't be the end. I'm ready for another shady attempt. Look what I've discovered behind my trash can. Not once but twice. How much drainage does he need? To go down.
Don't ask me, just do what you do. Okay. Meet me in the trail, it's going down. Meet me in the mall, it's going down. Meet me in the club, it's going down. Anywhere you meet me, guaranteed to go down. Meet me in the trail, it's going down. Meet me in the mall, it's going down. Meet me in the club, it's going down. Anywhere you meet me, guaranteed to go down. Verse number two, do the damn thing. Keys on my neck, pocket full of bent frames. When I'm in the mall, hoes just pause.
You ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head?
When your neighbor is asking to get dudes, WTF, he's at it again. I'm glad I witnessed this today. You reap what you sow.
You get everything you deserve.
when a woman handles DIY quicker than a man.
Nobody's gonna know.
They're gonna know. How would they know?
When a DIY gone wrong. I thought this would last until this city comes down.
Your office phone number, and you just told me that if I don't want to wait, I can leave. Is that what you just said?
Wait on me to talk.
And I said my time is important as hers, and I was here before her. No, you can step right here because this is where I was, and you walked off while I was talking to you.
We've got people to wait on. If you'll get right there, I'm going to focus just on you.
You
call the 800 number that's on my hour time.
No, I asked for your area number. Your area director's aided.
She has tailored to that.
It doesn't matter. She has a cell phone, and that cell phone is public knowledge. Yes, it is, because I lied for you guys.
If you don't want this, we're done. If you want to call the corporate number, it's on that right there. Someone got a sticker and put it on there, and I'm not going to sell that at that price. That sticker was put on there by somebody else.
And the only person that has the sticker guns to put it on there is your employees.
No, that was cool.
And that is, no, it was not. And that's not the first time I've come in here and you all have had something on that clearance rack that is priced incorrectly because your other manager, the little girl that has the blonde hair before she was demoted, I come in here and I got 17 items off of there and every one of those 17 items was priced incorrectly. So don't tell me it doesn't happen because it does. And then for you to be as disrespectful to walk off while I'm in the middle of a conversation with you because of something that you all did incorrectly to help another customer is bad customer service.
Someone else put that on there.
And then I'm asking you for your area manager's number and you're refusing to give it to me. And if I call the corporate office, they're going to give it to me because they're going to say you have to go through the area, the chain of command. You're going to have to call the corporate office.
Ma'am, I've seen you
in here
before.
I shop in here a lot, and I never have a problem. So for me to have a problem today, then that's an issue.
I've seen you with type of situation in here before.
You are a liar and a half.
I remember.
You're a liar, because every time I come in here, half the time, you're so incoherent, you don't even know what you're doing. And when you do know what you're doing, and you ring me up, we have no problems.
I remember you from the last time we had a conversation.
The last time we...
You were wanting to do some things that we couldn't do.
And what was those? What were those things? What were those things? Please remind me.
Okay, what you're going to need to do is...
No, what you're going to need to do is give me your area manager's phone number.
Ring message. You should check on this side right over here. Ma'am, I'm not kidding with you. Leave my store.
Call the police.
Leave my store.
You need me to call them for you? You need me to call them for you?
Listen, you're not going to be a smart ass with me.
Did you just call me a smartass?
I said you're not going to be one.
What gives you the right to call me a smartass?
I'm not calling you one. I'm telling you.
You just said it, and you're being recorded. So I have proof that you just called me a smartass.
No, I didn't. I said you're not going to be one.
No, you said you're not going to be a smartass. That's what you said.
I said you're not going to be one with me. And I'm calling right now.
Good.
Because you're refusing to keep my store.
Please do. Please do.
I need you, hold on just a minute. I need you to send the officer by my store. I have an irate customer that refuses to leave the store after being ordered. 5319 Ringo Road.
Now he's alive.
I'm the manager, Mr. Hughes.
I don't care what he says.
Be quiet. Be quiet. Be quiet.
There you go.
Karen trying to take items because she can't exchange used clothes.
You're leaving my store. Goodbye.
I am not.
Leave my store, ma'am. I'm telling you, I'm not the one you want to do this with.
You're back and give me a seat. Now give it to me.
Leave my store.
Come on.
Leave my store. Stop trying to steal my stuff. Leave my store. You're too old for this. Just leave my store. You are way too old for this. You're way too old for this. Leave my store. This is crazy.
So you're not going to leave unless you call security?
Okay.
I mean,
okay. Fine. Call security.
Leave my store. Leave my store.
Wait for
You're
it.
Not
she
stealing
hits her.
My items. Come on. Leave my store. You're too old for this.
Give me your girl.
Leave my store.
Oh,
leave. Leave
what
my
are you
store.
Doing? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Leave my store.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? What are you doing?
Don't put your hands on her.
Leave my store.
Don't put your hands
leave
on her.
Leave my store.
Where's the security?
Go.
Yeah.
You gotta go. Leave my store right
and
now.
And then she tries to take them again.
Leave my store. Do not come back here. Go! Go!
Don't
You're not
put your hands on
store.
Her.
Go. Do not
Don't
come back here.
Put your hands
Do not
on
come
her.
Back here.
What the fuck?
What the hell? What the hell?
No, I understand. I'm gonna place you on a brief hold, ma'am. Give me 1 second. I have the biggest fucking Karen on the phone ever, and I would just like you all to experience this with me. So as I was saying, because you missed your appointment yesterday, we sent a reminder text, we sent a reminder email. I actually remember speaking to you a few days ago regarding your appointment. We can't get you in today or tomorrow just because you missed your appointment yesterday. But again, like I said, I'd be more than happy to schedule you from 2 weeks from today.
You're not understanding. I don't want to come in 2 weeks. I want to come in today.
I understand, but because you missed your appointment, we don't have room today, nor do we have room next week. So I'm trying to help you out here and put you in for 2 weeks, and that's the best that I can do for you.
No, but I need my car fixed, so you're going to have to make space for me to come in today.
Do you want me to give you another number for another dealer?
Can you please take your dog out of the store? Like, that's illegal. You can't have a pet in the store. That's... Then you shouldn't have your dog in the store, ma'am. It's illegal. It's against the law.
It's not.
This is my service animal. As you can see, she's well behaved. And your dog is literally barking at us and distracting us. This is a seizure alert dog. Can you please back up? Can you please back up?
This
is a seizure alert dog. Can you please back up, ma'am? Can you please get out of here if you can't control your dog? This way. This way. This way.
She shouldn't be in the store.
You keep post. Skip. Plot. Good girl, Yuki.
What did you need?
Can we just...
If she can't handle being around a dog, wash her and get one that can.
Can we just hurry up?
What did you need, man?
I don't need that. It doesn't want to go.
I called somebody over here.
Thank you.
I need to sit down, guys.
Her dog started acting up. She didn't ask her to leave. She won't leave. She's a medical alert dog.
Do you see all these homeless people around? Are they dead in the streets with COVID? Hell no! Why? Where are the biohazards?
I recently put a bumper sticker on my car that says, "How's my driving?" And I put my own phone number on it. So people are calling and complaining about my driving to me as they're driving behind me. This one lady calls me. She's like, "Hey, one of your drivers just cut me off and flipped me off." I was like, "First of all, ma'am, I sincerely apologize for my driver's behavior. And second of all, you cut me off, bitch, okay?" And the only reason I flipped you off is because you're driving a Prius, alright? How'd you get a scarier car? Like a Fiat.
So I guess my neighbor does
here.
Not like my Hellcat.
I live here.
I live here too.
What's the problem?
Calm it down.
Calm what down?
Calm it down.
It's 1,000 horsepower. I was barely even touching it.
Loud muffler. Calm it down.
What are you going to... What?
I got your license plate.
I live right here.
I don't care.
What's your problem?
Calm it down.
What? How do you want me to dumb it down?
Calm it down. I know you live right here. I know you just bought here. Calm it down.
I've been living here for 3 years.
Don't do it.
Don't do what? It's 1,000 horsepower. What am I doing wrong? Exactly. Mind your damn business. Go on back inside.
You're holding up the line there, Karen.
Shut the fuck up, you fucking bitch. Record me all you want to before I spit on you.
Oh, no, Karen. Is that saliva out your mouth there, Karen?
I'm automatically a Karen because I walked up to
No, Karen, you're holding up the line. I need my McChicken and my McNuggets. Get out the line there, Karen. I'm going to eat my McChicken, my fries, and my drink. Get out the way there, Karen. Oh shit, stop that, Karen. I need my food to get more fatter, Karen. Watch out the way there, Karen. No, Karen, you're holding up the line there, Karen. Yeah, get out of here now, Karen. Thank you very much there, for it on.
You're the fucking Karen in my business, you stupid bitch.
For it on with those gun fingers there, Karen. All right, Karen.
So I bought this house 6 years ago next to the most insane people. This is their fence that was already there when I moved in, and they take it down in little spots about once a month so I can't let my dogs out. They say that I need to build a new fence so they can take theirs down. I can't wait for them to see what fence I build. Okay, I'm making a video to show you why this fence is old. It needs to be replaced anyway. That's his backyard right there. That's his back door. These planks need to be replaced. So while we're replacing this fence, we have decided that because he has started this problem, we are going to extend the fence past the windows. That's our window. And that's his window. So we're going to extend the fence all the way down. See what I mean? All right, well, we're going to sneak out here at night. And I'm going to show it to you in real life. Ooh, I look huge. There he is. You think you can see me in there? I can see like the side of his bed or something. I don't know. We're not the ones that called the police. We're not sure who it was, but I think it must have been these across the street neighbors, because this looks pretty shady. But anyway, our plan is to bring our fence out to cover the window. If anybody's wondering how we're going to fix this, that's how. Okay, you can see this one's our house. That one's his house. I'm not allowed to step on his lawn, is the way he puts it. So that's his two windows. Of course, he can close his blinds during the day. And then that's her window that he shined it into. And then you can see the little bitty window that's supposedly shining into his. Crazy.
Table there.
think for yourself, that's when you do stuff like you're doing. Go learn. Get an education, Danny. Then you can talk. You don't have to call me. What's the character from Saturday Night Live that you call me? You think I'm too dumb to know what you're doing? Clean up after your fucking dog. Clean up after your dog. We got PA. Clean up after your dog. Clean up after it. Hey, Daddy. Why you do it, Danny? What's your problem? Why, Danny? Danny, what the fuck is wrong with you? Why do you take a dump on the porch here? Yeah, you do, Danny, and you know it. Danny, what's wrong with you? You're a sick human being, Danny. It's Danny, so he'll do whatever the fuck he wants. And I look the other way, Danny, and I look the other way. Not anymore. Now I'm going to have him come and tear it down. You take it down and it gets torn down. Your legs. Take them down or they get torn down.
This was an interesting day. I come to my new house and they're building a fence. My landlord told me to call the cops, so that's what I did. The audacity to build a fence where we park our cars. And these Karens recording the whole thing. We told them that was illegal. We told them they could not do that. And they proceed to do what they're doing. So what I do, I call my landlord and I have him call his lawyer. Because this is what we're not going to do. Let me tell you one thing, from this day forward, they knew who the fuck I was. Look at them turn their backs. They didn't wanna see me. Here's their fence from my side and their side. How cute, right? Yeah, cute, but not cute for me to get in my driveway. Look, they expect us to go through that little ass space to get in our driveway. Then what I do, I call the lawyers and look, they had to take it all the way down. Cause this is what we're not gonna do. I'm going to get in my parking one way or another. You could tell they were mad, man. Did all that work putting it up, okay, now they have to do the work putting it down. Funny part was Karen's wasn't outside this time. Why is that? This goes to show I know what the fuck I'm talking about. I expect my car to be parked out there. They thought.
Thanks, honey.
I gave you the whole feet. The whole feet.
The whole $50, you know?
I don't know what you charged. I gave you the whole fee. Yeah. You told me the price, and I paid you the price that you told me. You said $48.
Yes, I told you. I told you this. You want? You want pedicure? You say no. You want?
I didn't ask for no pedicure. I didn't get no pedicure.
That's what I'm saying.
I didn't want no pedicure. I didn't get no pedicure. You said no pedicure. I said I just want my feet like that, and that's what I told you, and that's what I paid for. I don't see shit funny because I don't pay too much damn money.
Can you just do her toes so we can go?
She get my money back. So,
because I'm saying she's a dissatisfied customer. Just do her toes. She won't come back.
Okay, but okay. Right now, you know, she don't want a collar, right? I can for you $7 for the collar because I don't hurt your $7 for the collar. She don't want, I can $7.
You charge me $7. You said you charge me $7 to just polish 8 toes. I can go get some damn dollar polish and polish 8 toes by my damn self. You saying you charge me $7 for that?
You have a quillet. Yeah,
and that's paid for. That's paid for.
$13, right?
Exactly. I don't know what you charge. I know you told me $48 for my feet and my nails, and that's what I gave you.
No. Your nail already. You just paid the whole $20. Trendy because right now
it ain't no already. 18, you said my nails already, and I just paid the toll. You got one ticket. I gave you a $50 bill. You charged me $48, and then you gave me $2 back. It ain't no this is separate. You gave me one ticket, and then I paid you what you told me.
Okay, so what do you want her to do, Tasha?
I told you already.
Tasha. Okay. Tell her what you want her to do.
So you saying you're not going to give my money back or do nothing to my nails?
I left for you $7 back.
I'm not trying to hear you. You saying you're not going to give my money back or do nothing to my nails? I'm going to break up some shit in here and take out some shit.
No, you're not.